Noah here, Battle Kitty Mega Fan, and I just couldn't get enough of Ork and Kitty's adventures on Battle Island. I had to know more. So we went right to the source, series creator Matt Layzell, to compile the most interesting facts you didn't know about Battle Kitty. Let's get started. Battle Kitty has lots of influences, but the overall feeling producers Matt Layzell and his brother Paul wanted to generate within the show was playing Nintendo games on a summer day. Particular Nintendo series they were most heavily inspired by were Mario, The Legend of Zelda, and Animal Crossing, just to name a few. They also wanted to recreate the wackiness of classic cartoons like Wacky Races and Looney Tunes to the modern-day video game aesthetic. Pulling from cartoons through the ages, late 90s and early 2000s shows like Dexter's Laboratory and Powerpuff Girls were also big influences on the show's sense of humor. Even anime such as Gundam Wing and Dragon Ball Z also helped inspire Battle Kitty, especially with some costumes and battle scenes. The world of Battle Island plays on the trope of medieval-esque fantasy worlds, but through the lens of modern video game mechanics such as weapon upgrades and progression keys. Kitty and Ork's personalities were based on two sides of Matt Layzell himself, the extremely determined and feisty Kitty side, and the more apprehensive, gentle, and sensitive Ork side. These personalities of Ork and Kitty were also cultivated to be universally relatable. After all, there's a bit of Kitty and Ork in all of us. The interactivity and video game board design of Battle Kitty was the biggest and most exciting challenge for the extremely talented production team. Why was it so challenging, I hear you ask? Well, because it had never been done before on this level. Writing and creating episodes of Battle Kitty wasn't too different a process from creating episodes of Matt Layzell's previous series like The Amazing World of Gumball or Apple and Onion, only now with the help of the Unreal Engine. The interactive element, however, was a pioneering experience for the team, as they truly had to innovate when developing such a creative new concept. The overworld and episodic content were developed simultaneously, with Paul largely handling the overworld and interactivity and Matt on the story segments, working back and forth in brotherly cohesion. Main story episodes were outlined with traditional story structure in mind. You know, beginning, middle, and end. The side quests were viewed as an opportunity to further develop the cast of characters, as well as a fun chance to enjoy a more elaborate joke. The interactive overworld was first designed in 2D on paper and whiteboards. This included sprawling spider diagrams, arrows, you name it. Game designer logic was on the forefront during this initial phase. Wireframe designs were then implemented to establish and map out the different states of the map as it evolves through the series. Backgrounds and character animations were then added to the interactive map, with buttons being placed in precision, described by Layzell as an exact science. Australian animation and VFX studio Plastic Wax would then use these designs and data to fully bring Ork, Kitty, and the entirety of Battle Island to life. The show has a lot of subtle lore and world-building that you might miss on first viewing. For example, did you notice that most of the latter realms on Battle Island are the evil version of earlier realms? Such as the bright flashy Casino Woods, contrasted by the gloomy Dark Web Woods. Also, did you notice how the squires of Iago and Aeon seem to up and vanish after the race with Turbo Talker? In Matt Layzell's mind, they didn't exactly survive the early monster battles. But who needs squires when you're as strong and fabulous as Iago and Aeon? Big Lady Jane is actually implied to be the sole supplier of apples to Big Ork Island, and they obsess over their apple juice. Not only does she make the Ork King blast off again, she also cripples their economy. Layzell has made it clear that Battle Island and Ork Island are only one small part of a world full of diverse islands. Zaza's home of Royale Island is just one example, but think of the homes of all the other characters we've met with their own ambitions to become champion, even though nobody has ever become champion yet. Mysterious. Battle Kitty started out as a series of shorts debuting on Instagram. Much of the show and its characters blossomed from the surprising social media sensation. While Netflix's Battle Kitty is itself a wholly new creation unrelated to the shorts, a lot of the show's elements were conceptualized during this time. For example, Zaza Royale began as Boy Royale on Instagram. The overly famous and spoiled pop star vibe remained, but the expensive and futuristic accessories were pumped up. Plus, Zaza was given her ultra-stylish and ultra-dangerous ponytail. Some side quests within Kitty and Ork's adventures are actually direct references to segments from the original Instagram shorts. Superfans can spot them all. Matt Layzell always voiced Kitty and Ork on Instagram, and this is carried over to the show. But Layzell was beyond excited to work with such revered voice talent as Fred Padishore, Tom Kenny, and Phil Lamar. He really felt like he had to step up his game to match their abilities. Kitty has all sorts of bows throughout the series, enough to make a whole video about them. But unfortunately, some bows and other ideas didn't make the final show. One example is a skeleton bow that Ork and Kitty would have used to take on the grave monster. I'm sure even Skele-Kitty is still adorable. At one point, there was a quest planned wherein Kitty and Zaza are combined into one body. Rivalry hijinks surely would have ensued, but ultimately couldn't be fit into the show. There was planned to be a fleshed-out story arc revolving around the soul-stealing Axe of Bozark. In this episode, Kitty and Oryk would have been sucked into the Axe, meeting dozens of Zark clan souls hidden within. And by hidden, I mean hiding from the wrath of Gramzark. Battle Kitty was in development alongside the construction of Netflix Animation Studios. In fact, Matt Layzell had a close call when, during this construction, a chunk of ice nearly bonked him on the head while he was peacefully sitting. Fortunately, through this incident, in Matt's own words, that's when the inspiration for Kitty's ice bow hit him, / nearly missed him. Once united in their first studio, the whole Battle Kitty crew bonded over some rockin' karaoke, and over creating an awesome Battle Kitty mural on one of the walls. Drawing on the walls was common, as one wall was covered with whiteboard paint, allowing for some experimental takes on Battle Kitty's design. Seemed like a fun place to work? You bet. They even kept the gaming inspiration flowing with old gaming systems around the office and frequent after-work gaming sessions. The crew were especially obsessed over Super Smash Bros. And Tetris 99. There were Halloween parties, too. Aw, absolutely adorable takes on Oryk and Kitty. Matt Layzell's incredible cosplay of the Oryk King during a video quarantine party was particularly memorable. Matt Layzell kept receiving anonymous gifts on his desk throughout production, toys of Todd McFarlane's Spawn. After some time of being genuinely freaked out, it was revealed that supervising director Eric Fountain was the culprit, who was inspired by an early interview of Matt Layzell where he revealed that he would copy McFarlane's drawings as practice as a young kid honing his skills. Aw, how sweet. But Matt was a smidge embarrassed. Matt Layzell is certainly open to bringing Battle Kitty to the world of toys, clothing, video games, and more. He particularly would love to see Zaza Royale's silver workout gear. So obviously Battle Kitty was fun to make, but just how big of an interactive work did the Layzells really create? Just how many maps for the overworld were built? A whopping 31. Think that's a lot? Well, there's actually a total of 159 unlockable map layer states strewn throughout Battle Kitty's 9 episodes. It took 2.5 years of adding extra features and expanding Netflix's interactive framework in order to implement the entirety of Layzell's ambitious vision into the show. Wow, I thought I knew a lot about Battle Kitty before. Huge thanks to Matt Layzell for the amazing trivia and insight. Stay tuned to Netflix After School for more videos on your favorite animated Netflix shows. This is Noah. Thanks for watching.